Are you crazy? That's a good question. I think everyone that's skiing or doing action sport or taking photos or are creative is a bit of crazy. You need to be crazy to create something. So yeah, I'm crazy.
Yeah. Oh yeah!
Magnet.
I think we're going crazy.
It's snowing! It's snowing like hell!
My name is Daniel Ronnback. I'm 28, born in 87. I grew up in a town called Luleå in the northern part of Sweden, playing hockey from young age up to high school. During my last years in school, I really started to get more into skiing and for me to be out on my own and explore snow. I moved down to Orsa, which is a small town in the middle of Sweden, and started to study to be a ski instructor. And from here on, I started my journey on skis. I think my years as a ski instructor, where I was totally focusing on skiing, helped me a lot to do what I'm doing now, to shoot skiing in extreme environment. And I think that's one of two keys to be a successful photographer, is to be a really, really good skier, so you're able to go everywhere and ski everywhere. As I started to take photos, I started to shoot in a small ski resort. It's like 200 vertical meters and there is almost no powder. So you really need to be creative, and I think that's one of the keys to be successful as well, to see and to use the opportunities you have. I think, and what I learned through the years, that to be successful in something, whatever it's skiing, whatever it's taking photos, whatever it's football or getting a good education, it's time. You need to put the time into something. If you put the right amount of time and your own passion, you will succeed. During the years and trying to find inspiration from other things outside of skiing and take that to my way of shooting skiing. I think if you're really open and you listen and try to take in what everyone has, you can learn so much. The biggest difference between shooting skiing in a steep environment or shooting big jumps, powder jumps, or free skiing overall, it's not the actual skiing, it's all the safety aspects that you need to think about. The snow conditions, the weather changes, because the skiing itself, if you're there for that moment, I feel super safe and secure. Being out there on a super exposed place, there is so much more to think about, and I think this knowledge and those aspects is the one that take the longest time to learn, and the only way to get them in is being out there and getting that knowledge. And I'm really lucky that I've been working with people that has a lot of knowledge and that has spent a lot of time in the mountains. So I've always been trying to take in and listen to what they're thinking and what their plans are when we're out in the mountains. That's one of the most important things, is to listen to the mountain and to follow what the mountains tell you to do.
Thank you.